Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. This is group 1 presenting our video assignment for Usrah Budi 1. Our topic is the signs of Qiyamah. I am Abdurraafi from India, studying in the faculty of Fiqh and Usul. And with me, I have two other members. One is Brother Sakib from Bangladesh, and the other is Brother Muaz from Nigeria. I hope you enjoy, you learn something from this video lesson, and we'll continue with the different parts that we have to do. Let's jump into my topic first. When you talk about Qiyamah, we need to know what the word Qiyamah means. If you read in the Quran, you will find many topics that are mentioned in the Quran. The broad things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about in the Quran. The first one being that of Risala, the second one being that of Tawheed. And one of the other more recurrent topics that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about in the Quran is the topic of the Yawmul Qiyamah, the hereafter. And the Qiyamah is part of the hereafter, because the section of the hereafter starts when Qiyamah starts. And if you look at the linguistic meaning of the word Qiyamah, it is derived from the three-letter root word of Qaf Alif Mim, which means to stand, Qama. Qama yaqumu Qiyaman. Before we go into the technical meaning and the signs of the Qiyamah, we need to know what does the word Qiyamah mean literally. Linguistically, the word Qiyamah is derived from the three-letter root word in Arabic, Qaf Alif Mim. Qama yaqumu Qiyaman, which means to stand. So you can say that the word Qiyamah is to make something stand up. And technically, it is defined as the day of resurrection. It is the day in which all of mankind, from Adam alayhi salam to the last person on earth, male and female, rich and poor, black and white, of every nationality, of every color, people will be resurrected and stood out from their graves. And what will happen on this day? It is on this day all the accounting of the deeds will take place. The people who have done good deeds, and with the mercy of Allah, they will be destined to Jannah for eternal bliss. And those who have done bad deeds, or those whose deeds are short, they will be destined to the hellfire for eternal damnation and eternal misery. This is the Yawmul Qiyamah. Now that we have known about the linguistic and technical meaning of the word Qiyamah, it is important that we know what are the signs of Qiyamah. The signs of Qiyamah are events and things that will take place before Qiyamah actually starts. And the signs of Qiyamah are many. Some of them are mentioned in the Quran, and a lot of them are mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But before that, one might ask, why do we need to know about the signs of Qiyamah? It is important for us to know the signs of Qiyamah because so that we may prepare ourselves for the Qiyamah, so that we may do more good deeds and we may abstain from evil deeds. Why is this important? It is because once Qiyamah starts, all the doors of repentance are closed. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that the door of repentance is open as long as the sun does not rise from the west. This is because once the sun rises from the west, that is the signal for the beginning of the Qiyamah. And the signs of Qiyamah are divided into many parts. The majority of the signs of Qiyamah are known as alamatu sughra, or the minor signs. And a few of them are known as alamatul kubra, which are the major signs of Qiyamah. From the many signs of Qiyamah, as we have mentioned, there are some signs that are minor signs and some signs that are major signs. Among the minor signs of Qiyamah are the spread of ignorance, the spread of lying and liars, and the spread of nudity and immodesty. These are the minor signs of Qiyamah. And some of the major signs of Qiyamah are the appearance of Dajjal and the descent of Isa alayhi salam. These are the major signs of Qiyamah, as the scholars have classified. Some of these signs have already taken place and some of them are yet to take place. In the next few parts, we are going to discuss the signs of Qiyamah, that a few signs that have already occurred, and later on we'll discuss about the signs that are yet to occur. Thank you. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Baloku Muaz. I am from IRK James. This is an assignment from Usrah Budi. I will be talking about the signs of Qiyamah. First, sign of Qiyamah is the beginning of Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Qiyamah won't come during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam until after his demise. Then we can be expecting a sign of, that's number one sign of Qiyamah. Number two sign of Qiyamah is splitting of the moon. The splitting of the moon, the honor of judgment is drawing near, and the moon is cleft in two. The incident, apart from being a miracle of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is also a sign of Qiyamah and occurred approximately 5 years prior to the Hijrah. The third sign of Qiyamah is the evil ulama. Hadrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala says, Rasulullah said, a time is soon to come when Islam will remain only by name and Quran will exist only in words. People will erect large and beautiful masjid, but this masjid will lack guidance and deserted. The worst creation below the skies will be ulama and so. Great fitna evils will emanate from them, and then themselves they promote fitna, and they will be the center of fitna. Number four signs of Qiyamah is evil leaders. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a time will also come upon people when they will employ deceit in everything. A time when the liars will become truthful and the truthful will become the liars. The fifth sign of Qiyamah is wine. Hadrat Huzaifa radiallahu anha narrating Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when this ummah regard liquor as beverage, soft drink, interest as a profit and bribery as a gift, thereby attempting to legalize, that means make it halal, and when they conduct their business with zakat, then they will destroy as a result of increasing sin. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum brothers, this is Najmus Sakib. I am from Kulia of Engineering. Today our topic, the sign of Qiyamah. I will describe the last part, the events on the signs, those are yet to be happened. The number of men will decrease, whilst the number of women will increase, until for every man there are 50 women. This hadith have been came into Sahih al-Bukhari. Then comes the Euphrates will reveal a treasure of gold, and many will die fighting over it, each one hoping to be the one who gains the treasure. This sign have been came in Sahih Muslim. In another hadith, the Romans, Europeans will come to a place named Amak or Wabik, and an army of the best people will go forth from Medina to fight them. Then also comes in hadith, the Muslim conquest of Rome. The Mahdi, the guided one, will appear and be the Imam of the Muslims. Jesus Christ, that means Isa alayhi wasallam, will descend in Damascus and pray behind the Mahdi. Jesus will also break the cross and kill the swine, i.e. destroy the false Christianity. Then comes one important sign, the Antichrist, that means Al-Masih al-Dajjal, the false Christ, will appear with all his tools of deception and be an immense trial. Then comes the appearance of Yajuj and Majuj, they have been described in Quran. Then another sign, the emergence of the beast from the earth, carrying the staff of Moses and the seals of Solomon, who will speak to the people and tell them they did not believe with certainty of the divine signs. Now we move to a hadith where Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam have given us 10 major signs of Qiyamah. Muslim narrated that Hudhaifa ibn Asad al-Ghifari, may Allah be pleased with him, said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came out to us and we were discussing. He said, what are you discussing? They said, we are talking about the hour. He said, it will never begin until you see 10 signs before it. He mentioned the smoke, the Dajjal, the beast, the rising of the sun from its place of setting, the descent of Isa ibn Maryam, peace be upon him, Yajuj and Majuj, and 3 landslides, one in the east, one in the west, and one in the Arabian Peninsula. And at the last, that this is a fire which will emerge from Yemen and drive the people of their place of gathering. So the conclusion, the day of reckoning may not be as far as we would think to as we like to think. So we should focus on our ibadah and be a good Muslims. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.